Hi, YouTube. It's Ryan. I'm back. Third week. I'm doing it. I'm still doing these videos. I was wondering if I was going to quit, but so far so good. We're still here. I got a camera upgrade. I don't know if you guys can tell, but the camera is still a phone. I just got the Google Pixel. I was able to upgrade through Verizon, so yay. Still can't find a external microphone that works, so you guys still get to listen to my crappy audio that my phone's recording, but at least you can still hear me talk. So this week I wanted to talk about binging because it happened to me this weekend on Wednesday and Thursday. On Wednesday, it wasn't that bad. That emotional feeling that you get when you binge, if you are familiar with binging, it's rough, it's brutal, it's like feel empty. So I had that feeling, but I was good. I didn't go out and go buy fast food or junk food or soda or nada. I just went to the kitchen and I got some celery and I got some peanut butter and I made a peanut butter and jelly sandwich. I made a piece of buttered toast. I had a bunch of peanut butter. So it was just, it was still a lot of calories, but it wasn't McDonald's. So win, kinda. It's not a fun feeling and I don't like doing it. And if you haven't done it, then you won't really get it. It's, you have to have been there to, you have to walk in those shoes. But it really wasn't that bad. I did a good by me by not going out and spending money on garbage and eating it. So that's a good thing. I think that's a win. And so Wednesday, that was the worst day. Thursday was to the lesser extent. Wednesday, I went over my calorie count or over my calorie goal for the first time since I started tracking my food. And then, so I had that happen Wednesday, and then again, but not as bad, Thursday. I was under my calorie goal on Thursday still. And then Sunday at work, there was a birthday party. The GM's brother, his mother-in-law made a ton of Chinese food. She's a sweet old Cambodian lady, and she plays at my tables, and I had like 5 or 6 egg rolls. I had a bunch of chicken chow mein, a bunch of broccoli beef, a little bit of fried rice, and yeah, just kind of basic Chinese food, I guess. But it was delicious. I was looking forward to it. I knew it was going to happen. I planned ahead on my breakfast. I cut out my peanut butter and a couple other things to lower my breakfast calories to try to cushion the dinner because I knew it was coming, and I didn't go over my calories. But what I did do was I messed up my stomach. I haven't had greasy food like that in about a month, so it wrecked me at work. It was no fun, and it was a good lesson to know that, like, once you get good at eating good, like, eating bad makes you feel bad, and that's not fun either. So it's incentive to keep doing what I'm doing instead of going back to what I used to do, and that's a good thing too, I think. And even with all that, this morning, I weighed in at 400.4. So I'm like right there, under 400, almost, hopefully by next week. Last Tuesday was 402.7. So in these 7 days, I've lost 2.3 pounds, according to Mr. Scale. And feeling good. I binged. I had that crappy feeling, but I'm pushing through it. I'm not beating myself up. I'm happy. Ish, doing good. And so this week, after all that, that's kind of what I wanted to talk about. Calories were good, except for those 3 days. Everything was great. As great as it could be. Staying positive. And the only other thing I really wanted to say this week is I wanted to talk about taking lunch to work, because that is something that I've had a hard problem or a hard time doing forever, until it finally clicked that I don't want to eat the garbage at work, and I want to eat something healthy. I want to lose some weight. I want to be happier, to be me. And so I have goals now, and my goals are like, my big goal is getting my hernia fixed, like I said in my first video. So that's a lot of weight to lose. So like that's a big weight loss goal. Most people say like, start small, little goals, but like the thing I want to do most, the reason why I want to lose the weight the most is so I can fix the hernia, so I could be more active. I want to lift again. I want to do silly stuff that I used to do again, and I still do it, but I'm always in danger of making my hernia worse every time I do, except I don't lift because I know that that's a lot of strain in your abdominal cavity, and no. I want it to be fixable still. So I have goals, I'm working toward them, I'm feeling good, staying positive, and I'm taking lunch to work and dinner to work every day. Except Friday, I eat lunch at home, I start later. I bought a meal prep lunch bag that has room for three entrees, but I only take two and an ice pack and some salad dressing, so that's what fits in that compartment. I have has a top compartment where I take my snacks. I usually take like a banana and a couple apples, or an apple and an orange, or just stuff I can munch on. And then I have my water bottle, and I take a fork, and it's every day. And then I meal prep, and without further ado, here's how I make my meals. First thing I do is preheat the oven at 400 degrees. Then I cut up 3 heads of romaine lettuce and plate them for my salads this next 3 days. 1.5 cucumbers, I chop them up and add them to the salad. I add 2 tablespoons of unsalted sunflower seeds to the salad, and then I prep my dressings for the next 3 days. Then I cut up some sweet potatoes and season them with a little bit of olive oil and some spices, and then I throw them in the oven for 40 minutes at 400 degrees, and they come out looking golden brown and delicious. Then I season the meat with a little bit of powder and no oil. They just go right into the oven. They come out looking like that after 45 minutes at 350 degrees. Then we take our sauce, our veggies, 3 of the pork chops, and we dice them up. And we throw them into a skillet on medium-low heat. Add the sweet potatoes and the veggies and the sauce. And since I add water to the sauce, I get every drop of sauce out of the bottle I can. Mix it all together and incorporate everything really well. Set a lid on it to steam because I only want it to cook for just a little bit. I like my veggies crisp. We take the next 3 pork chops and we trim the fat off because they're going in the salad. And then we feed the trimmings to the dog because she adores them and begs incessantly. Dice it up, throw it in the salads, plate them, and then we plate the dinners and throw the lids on that, throw them in the fridge, and that's lunch and dinner for the next 3 days.
Thanks for tuning into my video this week, and I'd like you to comment and subscribe, maybe leave a like. All that fun YouTube stuff. I can't wait to have active discussions in the comments under my videos. Until next week, thank you.